Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to Lisa's Coloring Corner. Today I would like to do a flip through of this new book that I just received today. It is called Hatchdoodle Animals Coloring Book. Modern minimalist crosshatch color in art. Boy, isn't that a mouthful. Why I thought this book would be so interesting for those of us who love Sunlife Drawing books and love their one color art books, the lines and the lines and dots book. This book is very similar, and I have never seen another book that was similar to what Sunlife Drawing had out. So I thought I am going to try this book out. I just kind of looked at one or two pages in here, so I have not seen them all either. So let's look at them together. Now, this book is by Marc Weedbrook. Let me zoom you in. So that is his name. This book has been out for a couple years, but I had never seen it before. So let's look at what this looks like. It says, discover the power of cross hatching with pages formatted to trim into 8x10 frames, colored in, stand back and watch your art take form. So, here we have Hatchdoodle tips and tricks. It says, do one just with black to get used to this way of coloring in. Place a sheet of paper behind page to stop any color bleeding. Color upward lines first. These generally are lighter in color. Color your downward lines last, which generally are darker. Follow a line from start to end, even if it crosses another. This helps build up color in all the right spots. Smaller dots will be in line with either a line going this way or a line going this way and can be colored accordingly. Placing a ruler or edge of a sheet of paper under a line will help you see any other lines in the same row. Enjoy experimenting. Use alternating colors. Highlight each line. Cross with a metallic pen. Shade in between lines for a fuller effect. Patch hatch the paper before line coloring. Above all, have fun. And then they have an animal list down here which lists all of the animals that are in this book. So, while it kind of looks like Sunlife Drawings books, these are a little bit different. And I think, like it suggests, the first one or two that I do, I'm going to do just in black. And then I'm going to see what it looks like in just one color. And I may color all of these in one color. But I think I would also like to maybe take their suggestion over here, color the upward lines in a lighter color and the downward lines in a, you know, a darker color. So, yeah, doesn't this sound like fun? Okay, so as you can see, you really cannot tell what the picture is when you're just looking at the lines and the dots. Kind of like Sunlife Drawing. Once in a while, you could make out kind of what it was. But not always. And with these pictures, you really cannot tell. So I think they are going to be interesting because as you see, there's a line that goes over the top. Let's see. Lines that go over the top, and then there's a bunch that go underneath. So that's what they're talking about in the beginning of the book. The lines that go underneath, I believe, is what they said will be, yeah, the upward ones are going to be lighter. These downward ones you color last, which are generally darker. So we shall see. May color, okay, when you look at this one from far away, you can tell what that is. What about this first one? I'm looking at it close up and I couldn't tell what it was, but let me look on the iPad and see if we can see what it is. Not sure. Can't really tell on that one, but let's look through it and see if we can figure some of them out. I think this is going to be a lot of fun. Well, that must be a bear, huh? Like I said, just another take on the lines and dots. That must be a bunny. So yeah, I think I'm going to like this. Butterfly. What is that? Is that like a wolf howling at the moon or something? I can't tell. I know. You people are probably laughing at me and you're saying, no, Lisa, it's da la 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 la. Wolf howling at the moon. Ha ha ha. Okay. Maybe a seal? All right, we know what that one is. That one's easy enough. And, hippo maybe? I didn't want to look at the animal list in the front of the book because it would give them all away. There's a whale. Oh, that must be a duck, huh? Eagle. Yeah, I think these are going to be fun. There's an elephant. So I'm definitely going to be trying one of these. I'm probably going to try one out on my own off camera tonight and see what it looks like with one color and then maybe with the two color. And then I'll decide what I want to do on camera with you guys. I have a couple of other color and chats ahead of this one, so don't know what that is. That's an interesting one. Okay, we know what that is. Well, let me get this centered here. Don't know what that is. There's the hippo. And a horsey. And this is a book I'm probably just going to start at the beginning and go through it picture by picture. It looks like a lamb or a sheep. Must be another dog, maybe. An owl. Ooh, that's pretty. Panda bear. I love pandas. What is that? Is it some, must be some kind of big fish. Not sure. There's a penguin. Is that a pig? Oh, polar bear. Not much to do on this one, right? That would not take long at all. And I suppose if you wanted to put a background in here with pastels or something, you could do that. What is that one? Boy, I don't know that one either. At first down here, I thought maybe it was a stingray, but with this up here, I don't know. I know somebody out there probably can see it. I can't right now. Does it go this way maybe? Yep, shark. So I wonder if this one went sideways. No, that didn't help at all. I don't know. So maybe those other ones that I couldn't figure out were actually supposed to be landscape. Oh, a tiger. So I guess you can figure out most of them, huh? Okay, don't know what that is either. Let's try it. Must be a bird of some sort, right? Or is it like an armadillo or something? And that is it. You do have a couple sheets of a plain paper to test your mediums on. So again, that's Hatchdoodle Animals. So I'm going to kind of keep an eye out if I determine that I like this kind of coloring. And I'm going to look and see if there are any more, maybe besides the animals one. And if there are, I will bring those to you. I, as usual, will link this down below in case somebody else wants to go ahead and try this kind of coloring out. Again, in particular, if you like the Sunlife Drawing books like I do, and I know many of you do, you might want to check this one out. So, I thank you for watching this flip through, and if you liked it, please hit that like button and subscribe if you are new to my channel. I hope everybody's having a great weekend, and as always, happy coloring. Bye, guys.